I'm Fionnuala Sherry.
My name is Rolf Løvland.
We are Secret Garden, and we're absolutely delighted to be back in Guangzhou. It's 7 years since we were last here.
When we sort of started Secret Garden, and I think we connected in the thought that this is our music, it's very personal for us, it's very close to our hearts. It was very much based on the passion of doing music. It is about emotions, it is about touching people's hearts. And when I write music, it's driven by emotion, and it needs to be true to us, to be able to speak to people. So your question about spirituality and genre, you know, we're not so concerned about it itself, but we are very happy if that's part of the musical identity.
We're almost like messengers. It's certainly a very big compliment, you know, if you can touch somebody, and certainly in a performance. And we hear so many amazing stories from audience after concerts, and they tell us very touching stories. And music has that ability to communicate in a way that, you know, other arts can't. We don't consider whether it's new age or classical or pop. It's just the music that comes out of Rolf, and it's how we play it. Our music is also very much based on the traditions that we come from. I think you can hear a lot of Irish and Norwegian folk music in how we play, and that's because of our backgrounds. And maybe there is a little similarity with Enya for the same reason that she's Irish. She grew up with the same traditions and the same sense of music that I have.
We have some favourite songs, of course, because they all have special stories for us.
We talk about it when we're performing the title song to our very first album, Song from a Secret Garden. In a way, that song is like our own signature tune, because we've never done a performance without it. It means a lot to Rolf and I when we play that.
I think we have played that song probably 1,000 times, and we still don't tire of it. It always feels that there's something to discover, something new about it. And that's a good sign of quality also. You Raise Me Up, just a very versatile song, emotionally speaking. I think people can relate to it. It connects with people's emotions. I think they can read their own story into the song. A very important fact that it's been recorded by so many artists, and so it's out there in so many different versions. Josh Groban maybe my favorite. It speaks to young people and to old people and to every group of the population in a way. For instance, the pop version by Westlife as a pop ballad. It did not do that when we recorded it first in 2001. Writing music, for me, it's a necessity. I don't do it as a hobby, I don't do it because we need a new album or anything like that. I just need to write. I do it every day. And whether we are touring or not, I always have the focus on writing. It's just very important for me, it feels very good. That gives my life a lot of meaning. I think I've learned a lot from Fionnuala, from her classical discipline. She works very hard, rehearsing every day. I also like to work, I like to be inside my work, and Fionnuala inspires that a lot for me.
We're very good at compromising and working around each other. I think Rolf is a wonderful writer. I'm very blessed to have the job of interpreting his music. We still enjoy playing music together. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise